Hi everyone, today I will be sharing the best homemade healthy pizza recipe with you all. I've been having this pizza throughout the week because it's so yummy and much healthier than like bahar ka pizza. So if you guys want to know how even you can make this really simple, yummy and healthy pizza, then please continue watching. So here's an ingredient list for your reference. I'm making 3 regular pizzas, so even the quantities are according to that. Just change up the quantities depending on how many pizzas you want to make. You can pause the video here if you need to. First, for the pizza base, add the dry ingredients first, which is 1.5 cup of wheat flour, 1 teaspoon of salt, 3-4 teaspoon of baking powder, a pinch of baking soda, and 1 tablespoon sugar. Now mix the dry ingredients and then we can add around 3-4 cups of curd and knead it. Then add 1 tablespoon of oil and knead it again until soft. We're going to cover it and keep it aside for like 15 minutes. Until then, we can start preparing the toppings. Here, my mom is chopping tomatoes, onions, and capsicum. You can literally choose whatever vegetables you like on your pizza. I'll also be adding sliced jalapenos and of course, chili flakes and oregano. You can even add sausages if you're a non-vegetarian, which actually we were supposed to add, but then we forgot. So this will be a veg pizza. Next, we're going to grate the mozzarella cheese. We'll need about 200 grams. Now it's time to prep the base. Divide the dough in 3 equal portions and roll out the dough like you would while making rotis, except this will be much thicker. Once it's in like a decently round shape, we're going to prick a fork all over it. This is so that the base won't puff up. Next, we'll need to heat the tawa just like making rotis. So it can be on high heat for about a minute. And then we'll reduce the flame and put the pizza base on it. Also, if you're not using a non-stick tawa like I am, make sure to glaze the tawa with oil first before putting the pizza base. Once the base is on the tawa, spread approximately 1.5 tablespoon of pizza sauce on the base. Here I'm using homemade pizza sauce, which is super yummy. If you want the recipe, just DM me on my Instagram. But you can also use a store-bought pizza sauce, which also works well, but I just feel the homemade pizza sauce is healthier and tastier. Then you can add a thin layer of grated cheese. This is completely optional, but it just makes the pizza more cheesy, which I personally love. Then you can move on to add all your individual toppings, onions, tomatoes, capsicum, sweet corn, jalapeno, sausages, basically anything that you have. Next, sprinkle some oregano and chili flakes. Lastly, top it off with more of the grated mozzarella cheese. Don't forget to brush some oil or butter on the sides of the base for some glaze. Now close the tawa with a lid. If your lid also has a small vent like mine, just block it with a little bit of the same dough. Now cook this for about 7 to 8 minutes. After 7 minutes or so, you can check if it's cooked by lifting one side of the base slightly and just seeing if it has browned. If not, just keep it for a minute longer and then it should be cooked. And that's pretty much it. You have your very own yummy homemade pizza made with atta. This pizza is really, really good, guys. I wouldn't be sharing this with you all if it wasn't just really delicious. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this quick recipe video. Please do give this video a big thumbs up if you did enjoy it. And send me pictures on Instagram if you do end up trying this yourself. Also, if you have any questions or doubts regarding the recipe, please feel free to ask me in the comments. And that's it. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye! What a wonderful world.